Hey guys, Tyler here with Secure Team. Now, before we get into this video, I would like to thank all of you for your consistent and much appreciated viewership to our channel and the work we do. This week is a bit of a proud one for us here at Secure Team because we have just received via UPS delivery a Silver Play Button Award straight from YouTube, which we were selected for in congratulations for our reaching and surpassing of 100,000 subscribers to our channel. We are up to 110,000 subscribers to this very day. And this is just an awesome award depicting our Secure Team channel's name and the mighty sought after solid silver play button, which is encased in a glass frame and is now proudly hanging on our wall so we can see it while we work and have that constant reminder of how humble and lucky we are to have such an awesome subscriber base like you guys and just how much more we have to give you guys in terms of cracking the code to the alien question. So I wish to thank you all. I love you guys. And we'll keep rocking and rolling. So much love to everyone who supports us. Now, according to major reports and new images published by India's Mars Orbiter, which was launched by the Indian Space Research Organization on November 5th, 2013, has spotted what looks like a giant mushroom cloud on the planet's surface. Now, this image was taken by the onboard Mars Color Camera, or MCC. These images have been quickly uploaded to the ISRO's website with a great amount of detail. The large mushroom cloud was sighted in the Valles Marineris Canyon, which is located along the equator of the planet, which spans close to a quarter of the planet's circumference, looking like something out of a nuclear explosion. There looks to be a crater formed underneath the cloud. There isn't a logical explanation at this point about the cause of the cloud. There are many speculations swirling around of it being an actual nuclear mushroom cloud. And that's what it looks like to us here at Secure Team. Now, there is a book called Death on Mars, The Discovery of a Planetary Nuclear Massacre, written by Dr. John Brandenburg. And in this book, there is a telling of an epic story which suggests a full-scale war between ancient alien civilizations, and this mushroom cloud could be evidence of the result of a massacre, which has left isotropic traces of vast explosions that took place very long time ago, which we are now starting to see evidence of. The book goes on to speculate how Mars was once similar to Earth in its climate and became home to both plant and animal life governed by some sort of humanoid civilization, which have now been destroyed. Now, I don't know about you guys, but from all of the evidence brought forth thus far, from the multiple Mars rover images showing humanoid and alien-like skulls strewn across the Martian landscape, to even more photos of what look like machinery parts, alien craft, and other miscellaneous vehicles, some of which are partially buried and sticking up out of craters, to some of the more recent research by those who shy away from the official NASA story, which is that Mars is a dry, dead, cold, radiation-soaked wasteland, and bring about new theories based on the data sifted out from the piles of published images and information, and have come to the realization that Mars is very active. There are explosions erupting from the surface, seen from space, documented in multiple recent photos of the planet. And this new India image showing what I believe to be a true view of the Mars surface, where unlike with NASA, who deliberately edit all Mars photos, including these areas seen in the India image, or we can see these large eruption clouds in which they doctor, erase, blur, and distort until you don't see any eruption clouds at all, casting giant shadows on the surface below anymore, but you instead see these dry, dead canyons with no eruptions, no smoke, no clouds, and no evidence whatsoever. No evidence that would ever give you a second thought anyway to the fact that, as NASA wants you to think of Mars, as a dead body with nothing to show and nothing to be interested in. And people will then tend to overlook their doctored images and hopefully give up their search into this mysterious planet that I can assure you is much more alive than NASA will ever give us credit for. Now, Secure Team will be releasing a couple of follow-up videos detailing some of the single best Mars images and data that have been discovered, proving that these alien artifacts, vehicles, plant life, volcanic, and/or nuclear explosions very much do exist. Please, do not let NASA pull the wool over your eyes, because we'll be right here to pull it right back off. Be sure to head down to the video description and bookmark our Twitter page. Be sure to follow us as we post all of our new video updates and info to our Twitter in case you do not see our uploads in the Secure Team subscriber feed. And as always, be sure to check back, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you soon, guys. Stay safe.
A remarkable artifact has been found in Leonardo da Vinci's iconic masterpiece, the Mona Lisa. The artifact, which resembles a possible alien high priest, can only be seen when two halves of the image are mirrored and joined together. Once the image has been filtered, we can begin to see a mysterious figure emerge. If we strip away the image filters and apply some subtle colorization and highlights, we can clearly see that Da Vinci has hidden a possible alien gray within the brush strokes of his iconic painting. Once we add some color, shadow, and then highlight the obscure details, we can clearly see a small humanoid figure. We can clearly see two eyes, buried in deep-set sockets, here. We can also see a long thin nose, and a small mouth. The figure, which I have estimated to be around 3.5 feet in height, also appears to be wearing a head garment. It also appears to have a defined triangular-shaped anomaly, here. We can also see a similar-shaped anomaly between the humanoid's eyes, here. This could be a representation of the creature's pineal gland, or inner eye. As we move down the image, we can see two large objects, which appear to have long thin fingers. I would suggest that this is the decorative collar of the creature's robe. A little further down the image, we can clearly make out two small hands. We can clearly see fingers and two thumbs. We can also see two small ring-shaped objects at the end of the creature's fingers, here. Many theologians believe that Leonardo da Vinci deliberately concealed secret codes and subliminal messages in most of his work. If this is true, then it's reasonable to assume that the Mona Lisa was in fact painted in order to conceal important historical and religious facts, possibly regarding the extraterrestrial presence and its surreptitious involvement within the Roman Catholic Church. Remarkable images from the NASA archives appear to show two massive spheres and a possible cigar-shaped craft on the surface of the Moon. This image, which was snapped during the Apollo 14 mission, appears to show astronaut Edgar Mitchell looking at a huge ball-like object in the background. It would also appear that NASA have tried to hide this anomaly by manipulating the brightness and contrast of the image. However, we can do the same. By simply running the image through a filtering program, it's possible to bring out any details that NASA have tried to bleach out. As you can see, we now have a defined spherical object that is also reflecting light. The light source, which is presumably the sun, is emanating from this direction, here. We can also see that this half of the object is indeed reflecting light, while the other half remains in darkness. The second image, also taken from Apollo 14, appears to show a similar globe-like object in the background. Again, if we apply some filters, we can see that the object has a defined spherical shape and is also reflecting light. The final image, which was snapped during the Apollo 12 mission, appears to show a very bright illuminated hotspot. However, if we reduce the gamma and brightness of the image, we can clearly see that this bright anomaly could possibly be an object hovering above the lunar landscape. It's interesting to note that the Hasselblad cameras used in the Apollo missions had a pentagonal leaf shutter aperture. As you can see from these images, lens flare occasionally occurred when direct light entered the lens. However, this does not explain the spherical objects or the tube-shaped light anomaly. I have no idea what these objects truly are, but I would theorize that they are either solid objects of an extraterrestrial nature, or possibly further evidence that the Apollo moon images were photographed in a studio, probably using projected backgrounds with multiple light sources. A possible giant extraterrestrial creature has been photographed by an airline passenger over Austria. The remarkable photograph, which was snapped at 30,000 feet, by passenger Nick O'Donohue, clearly shows a huge mysterious figure, walking on the clouds. The massive figure appears to have a head, a large body with two arms, and two legs. The figure is also casting a defined shadow. We can assume, due to the altitude of the passenger jet, that this figure is not a reflection of a land-based building or installation. It's clearly something that is solid in nature, and clearly above the clouds, hence the defined shadow. It would appear, judging by this remarkable image, that a race of giant humanoid beings could actually exist somewhere in Earth's lower stratosphere. Many conspiracy theorists believe that extraterrestrial entities are possibly manifesting within supernatural phenomena in an effort to communicate or possibly even warn mankind. Until these mysteries are finally solved, we can only speculate at what they truly are. But if an extraterrestrial species are indeed trying to communicate with mankind, then I truly hope the human race will listen. Remarkable footage has emerged of a possible flying saucer observing the Apollo 15 crew on the moon.
Roger, Dave, that sounds good.
I tell you, looking even that way, the sun angle.
The footage, which was filmed by astronaut Jim Irwin, appears to show a saucer-shaped craft hovering on the lunar surface. As you can see, the object has a classic saucer design and color. It even appears to have a dome on top. We can also assume that the object is hovering above the lunar surface. We can clearly see the craft's shadow here. It would appear, judging by this official NASA footage, that the crew of Apollo 15 were being observed by an alien spacecraft during their mission to the moon. It would also confirm that there is indeed an extraterrestrial presence monitoring the NASA space program. Is it possible that an advanced extraterrestrial species are using Earth's moon as a secret base? If it is, then we must ask the question, why is NASA continuing to stay silent regarding the reality of extraterrestrial life, not just in our solar system, but on our closest neighbor, the moon?
Dave, we read all of that. We're getting a beautiful picture.
Morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Clifford Stone. I'm a Sergeant First Class United States Army. I had a secret clearance with Nuclear Assurity. I could get the clearance that I needed to do whatever it was that was necessary for me to do at the time on special operations when I was called in on those. What I'm referring to here is that I was involved in situations where we actually did recoveries of crashed saucers, for lack of a better term, debris thereof. There were bodies that were involved with some of these crashes, also some were alive. While we were doing all this, we were telling the American public there was nothing to it. We were telling the world there was nothing to it. But the whole situation is, we've set back, we've told the American people that there's no such thing as UFOs. I've been involved where we have recovered these objects. We know them to be of extraterrestrials. In 1969, I had an event that happened to me while I was stationed at Fort Lee, Virginia. We went to Indiantown Gap, Pennsylvania. That would be my first exposure to any time that we would be recovering an unidentified flying object. Later on, most people involved were to be told that there was nothing on board it. It was nothing more than just a crash of one of our aircraft. I know better because I was one of the people that approached it with a Geiger counter to get surface readings. I was the first person to go ahead and see that there were bodies on it. That would be the first of approximately 12 events. UFO crashes are not events that take place every day. They're rare. I know we're not alone in the universe. I know that the absence of evidence is not evidence of absence. It's evidence that has been denied to the American people.
information to the young people of the world in this country. They want to hear it. They want it. Give it to them. Don't hide it and tell lies and make stories. They're not stupid. They deserve it. It's their information. It doesn't belong to the Army or the Department of Defense. It's theirs. If it's classified, take the classification off and give it to them.
As you can see, the object has a classic saucer design and color. It even appears to have a dome on top. We can also assume that the object is hovering above the lunar surface. We can clearly see the craft's shadow here. It would appear, judging by this official NASA footage, that the crew of Apollo 15 were being observed by an alien spacecraft during their mission to the moon. It would also confirm that there is indeed an extraterrestrial presence monitoring the NASA space program. Is it possible that an advanced extraterrestrial species are using Earth's moon as a secret base? If it is, then we must ask the question, why is NASA continuing to stay silent regarding the reality of extraterrestrial life, not just in our solar system, but on our closest neighbor, the moon?
Dave, we read all of that, we are getting a beautiful picture.
Morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Clifford Stone. I was a Sergeant First Class, United States Army. I had a secret clearance with Nuclear Assurity. I could get the clearance that I needed to do whatever it was that was necessary for me to do at the time on special operations when I was called in on those. What I'm referring to here is that I was involved in situations where we actually did recoveries of crashed saucers, for lack of a better term, debris thereof. There were bodies that were involved with some of these crashes, also some were alive. While we were doing all this, we were telling the American public there was nothing to it. We were telling the world there was nothing to it. But the whole situation is, we've set back, we've told the American people that there's no such thing as UFOs. I've been involved where we have recovered these objects. We know them to be of extraterrestrials. In 1969, I had an event that happened to me while I was stationed at Fort Lee, Virginia. We went to Indiantown Gap, Pennsylvania. That would be my first exposure to any time that we would be recovering an unidentified flying object.
Later on, most people involved would have been were to be told that there was nothing on board it. It was nothing more than just a crash of one of our aircraft. I know better because I was one of the people that approached it with a Geiger counter to get surface readings. I was the first person to go ahead and see that there were bodies on it. That would be the first of approximately 12 events. UFO crashes are not events that take place every day. They're rare. I know we're not alone in the universe. I know that the absence of evidence is not evidence of absence. It's evidence that has been denied to the American people.
Give us information to the young people of the world in this country. They want to hear it. They want it. Give it to them. Don't hide it and tell lies and make stories. They're not stupid. They deserve it. It's their information. It doesn't belong to the Army or the Department of Defense. It's theirs. If it's classified, take the classification off and give it to them.
We can also see that this half of the object is indeed reflecting light, while the other half remains in darkness. The second image, also taken from Apollo 14, appears to show a similar globe-like object in the background. Again, if we apply some filters, we can see that the object has a defined spherical shape, and is also reflecting light. The final image, which was snapped during the Apollo 12 mission, appears to show a very bright illuminated hotspot. However, if we reduce the gamma and brightness of the image, we can clearly see that this bright anomaly could possibly be an object hovering above the lunar landscape. It's interesting to note that the Hasselblad cameras used in the Apollo missions had a pentagonal leaf shutter aperture. As you can see from these images, lens flare occasionally occurred when direct light entered the lens. However, this does not explain the spherical objects or the tube-shaped light anomaly. I have no idea what these objects truly are, but I would theorize that they are either solid objects of an extraterrestrial nature, or possibly further evidence that the Apollo moon images were photographed in a studio, probably using projected backgrounds with multiple light sources. A possible giant extraterrestrial creature has been photographed by an airline passenger over Austria. The remarkable photograph, which was snapped at 30,000 feet by passenger Nick O'Donohue, clearly shows a huge mysterious figure walking on the clouds. The massive figure appears to have a head, a large body with two arms, and two legs. The figure is also casting a defined shadow. We can assume, due to the altitude of the passenger jet, that this figure is not a reflection of a land-based building or installation. It's clearly something that is solid in nature and clearly above the clouds, hence the defined shadow. It would appear, judging by this remarkable image, that a race of giant humanoid beings could actually exist somewhere in Earth's lower stratosphere. Many conspiracy theorists believe that extraterrestrial entities are possibly manifesting within supernatural phenomena in an effort to communicate or possibly even warn mankind. Until these mysteries are finally solved, we can only speculate at what they truly are. But if an extraterrestrial species are indeed trying to communicate with mankind, then I truly hope the human race will listen. Remarkable footage has emerged of a possible flying saucer observing the Apollo 15 crew on the moon.
Roger, Dave, that sounds good.
I tell you, looking even that way, the sun angle.
The footage, which was filmed by astronaut Jim Irwin, appears to show a saucer-shaped craft hovering on the lunar surface.
Thank you.
A remarkable artifact has been found in Leonardo da Vinci's iconic masterpiece, the Mona Lisa. The artifact, which resembles a possible alien high priest, can only be seen when two halves of the image are mirrored and joined together. Once the image has been filtered, we can begin to see a mysterious figure emerge. If we strip away the image filters and apply some subtle colorization and highlights, we can clearly see that Da Vinci has hidden a possible alien gray within the brush strokes of his iconic painting. Once we add some color, shadow, and then highlight the obscure details, we can clearly see a small humanoid figure. We can clearly see two eyes, buried in deep-set sockets, here. We can also see a long thin nose, and a small mouth. The figure, which I have estimated to be around 3.5 feet in height, also appears to be wearing a head garment. It also appears to have a defined triangular-shaped anomaly, here. We can also see a similar-shaped anomaly between the humanoid's eyes, here. This could be a representation of the creature's pineal gland, or inner eye. As we move down the image, we can see two large objects, which appear to have long thin fingers. I would suggest that this is the decorative collar of the creature's robe. A little further down the image, we can clearly make out two small hands. We can clearly see fingers and two thumbs. We can also see two small ring-shaped objects at the end of the creature's fingers, here. Many theologians believe that Leonardo da Vinci deliberately concealed secret codes and subliminal messages in most of his work. If this is true, then it's reasonable to assume that the Mona Lisa was in fact painted in order to conceal important historical and religious facts, possibly regarding the extraterrestrial presence and its surreptitious involvement within the Roman Catholic Church. Remarkable images from the NASA archives appear to show two massive spheres and a possible cigar-shaped craft on the surface of the moon. This image, which was snapped during the Apollo 14 mission, appears to show astronaut Edgar Mitchell looking at a huge ball-like object in the background. It would also appear that NASA have tried to hide this anomaly by manipulating the brightness and contrast of the image. However, we can do the same. By simply running the image through a filtering program, it's possible to bring out any details that NASA have tried to bleach out. As you can see, we now have a defined spherical object that is also reflecting light. The light source, which is presumably the sun, is emanating from this direction, here.
Hey guys, Tyler here with Secure Team. Now before we get into this video, I would like to thank all of you for your consistent and much appreciated viewership to our channel and the work we do. This week is a bit of a proud one for us here at Secure Team because we have just received via UPS delivery a Silver Play Button Award straight from YouTube, which we were selected for in congratulations for our reaching and surpassing of 100,000 subscribers to our channel. We are up to 110,000 subscribers to this very day. And this is just an awesome award depicting our Secure Team channel's name and the mighty sought after solid silver play button, which is encased in a glass frame and is now proudly hanging on our wall so we can see it while we work and have that constant reminder of how humble and lucky we are to have such an awesome subscriber base like you guys and just how much more we have to give you guys in terms of cracking the code to the alien question. So I wish to thank you all. I love you guys, and we'll keep rocking and rolling. So much love to everyone who supports us. Now, according to major reports and new images published by India's Mars Orbiter, which was launched by the Indian Space Research Organization on November 5th, 2013, has spotted what looks like a giant mushroom cloud on the planet's surface. Now, this image was taken by the onboard Mars Color Camera, or MCC. These images have been quickly uploaded to the ISRO's website with a great amount of detail. The large mushroom cloud was sighted in the Valles Marineris Canyon, which is located along the equator of the planet, which spans close to a quarter of the planet's circumference, looking like something out of a nuclear explosion. There looks to be a crater formed underneath the cloud. There isn't a logical explanation at this point about the cause of the cloud. There are many speculations swirling around of it being an actual nuclear mushroom cloud. And that's what it looks like to us here at Secure Team. Now, there is a book called Death on Mars, The Discovery of a Planetary Nuclear Massacre, written by Dr. John Brandenburg. And in this book, there is a telling of an epic story which suggests a full-scale war between ancient alien civilizations, and this mushroom cloud could be evidence of the result of a massacre, which has left isotropic traces of vast explosions that took place very long time ago, which we are now starting to see evidence of. The book goes on to speculate how Mars was once similar to Earth in its climate and became home to both plant and animal life governed by some sort of humanoid civilization, which have now been destroyed. Now, I don't know about you guys, but from all of the evidence brought forth thus far, from the multiple Mars rover images showing humanoid and alien-like skulls strewn across the Martian landscape, to even more photos of what look like machinery parts, alien craft, and other miscellaneous vehicles, some of which are partially buried and sticking up out of craters, to some of the more recent research by those who shy away from the official NASA story, which is that Mars is a dry, dead, cold, radiation-soaked wasteland, and bring about new theories based on the data sifted out from the piles of published images and information, and have come to the realization that Mars is very active. There are explosions erupting from the surface, seen from space, documented in multiple recent photos of the planet. And this new India image showing what I believe to be a true view of the Mars surface, where unlike with NASA, who deliberately edit all Mars photos, including these areas seen in the India image, where we can see these large eruption clouds in which they doctor, erase, blur, and distort until you don't see any eruption clouds at all, casting giant shadows on the surface below anymore, but you instead see these dry, dead canyons with no eruptions, no smoke, no clouds, and no evidence whatsoever. No evidence that would ever give you a second thought anyway to the fact that, as NASA wants you to think of Mars, as a dead body with nothing to show and nothing to be interested in. And people will then tend to overlook their doctored images and hopefully give up their search into this mysterious planet that I can assure you is much more alive than NASA will ever give us credit for. Now, Secure Team will be releasing a couple of follow-up videos detailing some of the single best Mars images and data that have been discovered, proving that these alien artifacts, vehicles, plant life, volcanic, and/or nuclear explosions very much do exist. Please, do not let NASA pull the wool over your eyes, because we'll be right here to pull it right back off. Be sure to head down to the video description and bookmark our Twitter page. Be sure to follow us as we post all of our new video updates and info to our Twitter in case you do not see our uploads in the Secure Team subscriber feed. And as always, be sure to check back, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you soon, guys. Stay safe.